Hi, I'm Sandy. Welcome to Aunt Sandy's Kitchen. I got started cooking when I was about 6 or 7. I got an easy bake oven for Christmas that year. And my sister and my brother got a hold of it before I could. I remember her fixing the little cake that you put into the oven. But that's where I got my passion for cooking, start of it anyway. And I'm from a big family. I'm the youngest of 7. I was young and when my mother passed, and so I learned how to cook really from my stepmother and my sister-in-laws. They were a big influence in my way of cooking. I learned to make biscuits from my stepmother, Elizabeth. And she had this metal container that she just kept flour in. And that's the old, you know, you just stick your shortening or lard or whatever in your buttermilk in there and swish it around. And you just keep using that container. I can't remember what it was, but it was some kind of metal container. And she taught me how to make biscuits. And then my sister-in-law, Estelle, taught me how to make biscuits without touching the dough, because I was a teenager back then and I didn't like anything sticky on my fingers. So she taught me the other way. So I know how to do them both ways. One I learned how to cook was from my dad. He showed me how to make gravy. The first batch burned up, so we had to start again. And we were making pork chops that day, fried pork chops. And you got to have gravy with it. And I asked him, I said, "Where'd you learn how to cook, Dad?" And he said, "In the Army, sister." And he just, you know, I thought he was doing one of his jokes. Later in life, I did Ancestry.com on my family, and sure enough, he was in the Army for a while anyway. But he could cook when he wanted to. Elsie, my mother-in-law, I met her in 1977. That's when Kenneth and I got married. And a couple of years later, we moved to Florida, Tampa, Florida, to be exact. That's where Kenneth was born and raised. And I learned how to make all kind of Spanish dishes from my mother-in-law, Elsie. It's a wonderful culture down there and wonderful food. And she taught me how to make bean soup, chicken yellow rice, how to make Cuban sandwiches, and it was just wonderful. Mr. Cook, Kenneth's father, he ran restaurants down in Tampa, and so she was around a lot of great chefs, and that's where she learned how to cook too. But she was one of 9, I think, and so she was from a big family, and I just learned how a lot of recipes from her that I still have to this day in her handwriting that she's passed down. And I just love learning how to cook different dishes, different culture dishes. My favorite foods, that's a hard one. I like about just anything except fish. Sorry for those fish lovers right there. But Italian, Mexican, I just like just regular homegrown vegetables, southern cooking, that's what I usually do. I love to bake, and I love to make desserts and different things. My favorite meal, it's got to be breakfast. I love breakfast, breakfast foods, any kind of breakfasts. I was the youngest of 7, and I think all of them love breakfast just about the same as I do. I like it breakfast, for lunch, or for dinner. We used to have breakfast growing up. We used to have it for dinner. If there was one particular one, that I had to pick, would be breakfast with all the trimmings. I got sick during COVID in July 31st. I had to be rushed to the hospital, and for 5 or 6 weeks, the only thing I remember is getting to the ambulance. And then I woke up and I was in the hospital. So I was real sick. I couldn't hardly move. I had different wounds from one end to the other. I had a ventilator, I had a hole in my throat, and my leg wouldn't move very much. And so I've come a long ways. And so that's why I have to sit down and cook, because I can't stand very long. After I was started feeling better, I couldn't cook for about a year, I think it was. And so I wanted to get in the kitchen and cook. And so I decided, I'll just pull me up a chair and in there and start cooking. So that's how I started cooking again, is cooking in a chair. And hopefully, eventually, I'll be able to stand long enough to cook like I used to. Because I'm walking now and doing better. We came up with Aunt Sandy's Kitchen because I love to cook. I'm an aunt. I have a lot of nephews and nieces. I've lost count. I would make them Rice Krispie treats, brownies, chicken and dumplings, banana pudding, whatever they wanted. And so I thought, I'm not going to be here forever, so they need to learn how to make this stuff. Because they would call me and ask me for the recipe, or call me and ask me, would you make this for me, or make this or make that. And so I said, I need to do something about this. So that's why I started Aunt Sandy's Kitchen, so they can just pop on the TV or whatever computer and watch me make it, and they can make it themselves. And so they'll have it forever. After I'm dead and gone, they'll have it so they can make it for their families and pass it on to their kids, so it'll always be with them. I hope you enjoy these videos, these cooking videos that I'm making, and you learn something and how to cook something. I just love to teach, show people how to cook, what I've learned through all the years, the mistakes I've made. I probably could throw some hints in there to make it faster, do it a different way, or, cut out the shortcuts and stuff. But, I just want people to enjoy my videos and maybe learn something. If you don't, then that's fine. But I just want everybody to enjoy just cooking for your family, cooking for your neighbors, things like that.